Good morning, everyone. We welcome you from near and far to the Church of the Immaculate Conception in Glenville, New York. Today is Monday, September 21st, and it is the Feast of the Apostle St. Matthew. Today our presider is Father Leo Markert. We welcome him and we thank him for all that he does for us here at Immaculate. But as always, before we begin, we remember in our prayers our fellow parishioners who have died on this date. Stephen Zoltan, 1983. Anne Pasternak, 1985. Judith Sims, 1993. Mary Dowling, 2013. And Helen Giametti, 2013. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. And may their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
And with your spirit.
As we gather on this feast of the St. Matthew, Apostle and Evangelist, may we call to mind our sins and ask God for our forgiveness. For in those times we fail to appreciate the gift of the Holy Scriptures, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
And the time we fail to live up to the Scriptures prescribed for our lives and holiness, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you are also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. But grace was given to each of us according to the measure of Christ's gift. And he gave some as apostles, others as prophets, others as evangelists, others as pastors and teachers, to equip the holy ones for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until we all attain to the unity of faith and knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood to the extent of the full stature of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Their message goes out through all the earth.
Their message goes out through all the world.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day pours out the word to day, and night to night imparts knowledge.
Their message goes out through all the world.
Not a word nor a discourse whose voice is not heard. Through all the earth their voice resounds, and to the ends of the world their message.
Their message goes out through all the earth.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. So you know who I am. My name is Matthew. And if you read my fellow evangelist writings in the Gospels, Luke and Mark, they call me Levi, maybe my nickname, but my real name is Matthew. I'm a Jew, but I wasn't very popular among my Jewish brothers and sisters. You know why? Because I was a tax collector. I suppose you could call me the Roman IRS. And taking the money from my brother and sister Jews for the taxes and then handing it over to the Roman government, I was not a popular person in my families of the Jewish people. And one day, a fellow Jew came along. His name was Jesus. And he said to me, "Follow me, follow me." And I left my family and I gave up my job. A lot of people were happy about that. And I followed for 3 years Jesus, who taught me so much. And although I was so happy to be part of this group called apostles, I had a wonderful celebratory dinner at my house. And in follow my invited my brother, tax collectors, and Jesus. Jesus saw in me, as he sees in all of us, a potential for goodness. He sees a potential for holiness. And he calls all of us to follow him, each one of us here today. But he called me and I said, "Yes, Lord. Here I am. I come to do your will." And I learned so much, and I wrote this gospel. And then, after Jesus died and rose and went back to the Father in heaven, I proceeded on my mission to spread this good news. My gospel was mainly written for Jewish converts to Christianity. And I would show in my gospel the evolution from Judaism into Christianity and how many of those prophecies were fulfilled in Jesus. And then in my travels to proclaim the good news, I ended up in Ethiopia, where I was killed for the faith. I invite you to say yes to Jesus every morning and every night. I invite you to say yes to the promptings of the Holy Spirit. I invite you to say, "Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will, not mine." Let us now pray. Lord God, we have heard the holy words of Jesus in Matthew's gospel today, that each one of us may treasure the word of God as we hear it each day, and then leave and follow what it says, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for Matthew and all the evangelists and writers of the scripture for teaching us so much about Jesus and our faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have left the church, the sacraments, God's friendship, may they know that God will never break that friendship, and we pray for their return. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, the dying, the incarcerated, the unloved, and the addicted, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the sick and dying, and for all our faithful departed, and for your personal intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, for these many said and unsaid petitions that we hold within our hearts, we gather before you this morning. We know you will hear our prayers and answer them according to your holy will. And this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer you. Food of the earth and work of your own hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God.
Christ in me, our lives, and dispel all the darkness. Christ in me, our lives, with your power and your strength.
Who humbled himself to share it.
Christ in me, pour out your mercy and healing. Christ in me, our
My brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we celebrate anew the memory of St. Matthew, we bring you sacrifices and prayers, O Lord, humbly imploring you to look kindly on your church, whose faith you have nourished by the preaching of the apostles. And all this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for you, eternal shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed as shepherds, to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
O holy, O holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat
this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop, Edward, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially for whom this Mass is being offered. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her husband, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, Saint Matthew, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Please may we share that peace with one another. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Please join me in the prayer of spiritual communion. I wish, my Lord, to receive you with the purity, humility, and devotion with which your most holy mother received you with the spirit and fervor of the saints.
Let me the green.
Let us now pray. Sharing in that saving joy, O Lord, with which St. Matthew welcomed the Savior as a guest in his own home, we pray, grant that we may always be renewed by the food we receive from Christ, who came to call not the just, but sinners to salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. May God, who has granted you to stand firm on apostolic foundations, graciously bless you through the glorious merits of the Holy Apostle, St. Matthew. And may he, who endowed you with the teaching and example of the apostles, make you, under their protection, witnesses to the truth before all. Amen. So that through the intercession of the apostles, you may inherit the eternal homeland. For by their teaching, you possess firmness of faith. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace, loving and serving God and one another.
Thanks be to God.
God, we praise thy name, Lord, of all we bow before thee.